conductor and insulator. We can classify the material generally according to the ability of charge to move through them. Conductors. Conductors are material through the which charge can move rather than freely. For an example, include metal such as copper in common lamp wire, the human body and tap water. Non-conductor. Non-conductor also called insulator or material through which charge cannot move freely. For an example, include rubber such as the insulation and common lamp wire, plastic, glass and chemically pure water. Semiconductor. Semiconductors are materials that are intermediate between conductors and insulator. For an example, include silicon and germanium in computer chips. Superconductor. Superconductor are materials that are perfect conductor, allowing charge to move without any hindrance. Conducting path. Here is an example of how conduction can eliminate excess charge on the object. If you rub a copper rod with wool, charge is transferred from the wool to the rod. However, if you holding the rod while also touching the butt cut, you cannot charge the rod in spite of transfer. The reason is that the rod and the bow set are all conductor is connected, while the plumbing to air surface, which is a huge conductor, because the excess charges put on the rod by the wool ripple one another. They move away from one another by moving first through the rod, then through you, and then through the faucet and plumbing to reach air surface, where they can spread out. The process of leaves the rod electrically neutral. In this, setting up a pathway of conductor between an object and earth surface, we are said to ground the object, and in neutralizing the object by eliminating and unbalanced positive or negative charges, we are said to discharge the object. In this, setting up a pathway of conductor between an object and earth surface, we are said to ground the object, and in neutralizing the object by eliminating and unbalanced positive or negative charges, we are said to discharge the object. If instead of holding the copper rod in your hand, you hold it by an insulating handle, you eliminate the conducting path to the earth, and the rod can then be charged by rubbing. The charge remaining on the rod as long as you do not touch it directly with your hand. Charged particle. The property of conductor and insulator are due to the structure and electrical nature of atoms. Atom consists of positively charged proton, negatively charged electron and electrically neutral neutrons. The proton and neutrons are packed tightly together in a central nucleus. The charge of single electron and that of single proton have a same magnitude but are opposite in sign. Hence, an electrically neutral an atom contains equal number of electron and protons. Electrons are held near the nucleus because they have the electrically sign opposite that of proton in the nucleus, and thus are attracted to the nucleus. Where this is not true, there would be no atoms and thus no you. When atom of conductor like copper come together to form a solid, some of their outermost like and so most loosely held electron became free to wander about within the solid, leaving behind positively charged atom is like a positive ion. We call the mobile electron conduction electron. There are few free electron in a non-conductor. Induced charge. You can see the image of the diagram. It is demonstrate the mobility of charge in conductor. The negative charged plastic rod will attract either end of an isolated neutral copper rod. What happens is that many of conduction electron in the closer end of copper rod are repelled by the negative charge and the plastic rod. Some of the conduction electron move to far end of the copper rod, leaving the near end deflected in the electron and thus with an unbalanced positive charge. This is positive charge is attracted to the negative charge in a plastic rod. Although the copper rod is still neutral, it is said to have an induced charge, which means that some of its positive and negative charges have been separated due to the presence of nearby charges. Similarly, if a positively charged glass rod is brought near to one end of a neutral copper rod, induced charge is again set off in the neutral copper rod, but now the near end gains conduction electron, becomes negatively charged and is attracted to the glass rod, while the far end is positively charged. Note on that only conduction electron with the negative charges can move. The positive ions are fixed in a place. Thus, an object becomes positively charged only through the removal of negative charges.